go too loud.
No, no. No, I think I blew my ears off of that. That plane took off, so. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah. Yeah, remember, your volume?
Yeah, I remember.
Yep, only controls your how it hears to you.
Yeah, that's good there.
Okay, I'm gonna text it out so you can see when those jumpers are down.
Right.
That radio is way too loud. It's the on the panel up ahead.
Oh, okay.
It's the right hand knob.
Okay. When he's talking, I'll get it again.
Yeah.
That's the volume, the right hand knob.
Correct. Okay. Well, some of the jumpers are down at least.
Well, the other right up over our wing. There's two more up there that I see. Last mile, he won't be long.
Yeah, here's the King Air.
You see him?
Yeah, he's getting ready to turn final.
Oh, okay. I'll get the radio when he talks again. Oh, there's another one up here, wow. Coming right over the wing, I couldn't see him.
Yeah.
So he's falling out of the sky, that yellow one right there. It'd ruin their whole day if you come flying through, wouldn't it? What?
Wouldn't make any friends.
No, I don't think so. Oh, we went up one time, I think it was Jefferson County Airport, it was north edge of Denver, and a guy had a Piper Cub J3, I went up in it, man, they had jumpers all over the place, it was, oh God, it was hairy. Well, I lost track of that King Air.
Yeah, he kind of looped around, and I think he's just playing a really long
like he's going over that way, I don't know. There's a jumper up there, he's just kind of hanging there. You probably see him, can't you?
Yeah.
There's another one right here. God, can't see him above your wing.
Santa Fest, 1 Whiskey Lima.
Is that okay?
Go ahead. Hey, the gear indicators, were they having any intermediate function with those? I got two out of the three. I think it's the way the land is sitting.
You can try unscrewing it and re-screwing it. They did have that out to get part numbers
that okay?
from that
a little lower
gauge in there for the flap gauge.
That ought to be good.
Yeah, but I'm talking about you're talking about the gear lights, right?
Yes, sir.
He must be watching the jumpers. He's
tried taking it out and re-screwing it back in.
That's it.
I don't have any desire to do that at all. What's your plan? Are we gonna go over to Box Eye or Bullseye?
Yeah.
Or what? I just like to try if we can.
Yeah.
Just some, you know.
I'm just gonna go ahead and take off. I was waiting for that King Air, but
I don't know where he went. I don't see any wind. Oh, there's a stock over there.
Yeah.
So he should be coming in here somewhere, but I don't know where he went. You gonna use the dirt?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think he will. gas, so
got plenty of gas.
Right.
And
Colorado Springs, the King Air 1 Whiskey Lima, we're short final runway 35.
35. Is this 35 over here?
Yeah, unless he's confused and he's going the opposite direction.
He might be. He was confused earlier, remember? I bet he is.
Ready to go?
Ready.
All right.
not blocked off, you can... What a great place to practice if you can do that.
Oh, boy, having a look.
Yeah.
apart. You got cramps and you got tension.
Yeah, well, sometimes you just gotta shift around a little bit. Take care of it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's still there. I don't know why. Than earlier as far as the wind.
Uh-huh.
I had no idea there's so many houses right out in here. Is this Ellicott here? Or
yeah, Ellicott is right, yeah, just right out over there. That southern part over there is Ellicott.
Okay.
The crow hop, the most dangerous part is if you try and land it at too fast of a speed.
Oh,
so
yeah.
You gotta very deliberately make the
Spring Beach Airport, jumpers away from 16,000, Colorado Spring Beach.
Yeah, you know, I want to watch it because, you know, getting it up, what, level it off and.
Yep.
And then don't pull back because the nose is going to go up. So.
Right. And you got to come off the power almost immediately.
Oh, yeah.
Otherwise, you're going to start climbing out.
That's what I thought,
You'll eat up your runway really quick.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Ready to go?
Ready. Yeah, go ahead.
Thank you.
got jumpers up here. Wow.
Yeah, that was not a very good crow hop.
Oh, that's okay. I was.
Problem is, it, you know, being hot and heavy, it's just not accelerating up to flying speed real great.
Yeah, I thought it would get it, but it was supposed to be the heat, isn't it? Because we got off pretty quick this morning. No way I'm going to get that tub up in the plane in a hurry. Not sure. I really don't want to. That bus tub, then he's going to walk away, and I got parts.
Yeah.
I don't want to do that.
Planted.
You see that guy over there?
Yeah.
Yeah, he came in hard. That guy, all of a sudden, there was a chute and there was a body just going in. Yeah, they're all over the sky. They're coming in over there, though.
About
three up here and one's way over there somewhere. Yeah, I don't know what he was doing. He tried to take off or something. God. Have you done that? Probably.
Yeah, I have a few times.
Really?
It's fun. It's not something I'm terribly passionate about, but
no,
I enjoy it.
Do you really? I'm going to get my foot off those rudders. I'm gonna cross them on this support up here because I got to stay away from rudders.
Springs East, King Air's left base at a short final, runway 35. Springs East.
You got to be kidding me. You want to make an announcement on the ring?
Nah, we're just going to get out of the way.
I don't even see him. He's probably coming in the same way. I don't see him.
Colorado Springs East, King Air, turn to final, 35, Springs East, full stop.
Oh, another butt plant.
Oh, man. That hurts.
That was a tandem.
Was it?
Yeah.
Jeez. God, that just didn't do anything for me. Oh, there's the King Air up there.
Yeah.
He's just about above the sock there.
See a few other chutes in the air still.
Are they? Golly.
Tandem. We'll see if he butt skids it in.
I know a few people that have done that, and they're paying for it. Their knees are history right now. They've had it replaced, and...
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty good.
That wasn't bad.
Hopefully they look for some cactus before they, that would hurt. Oh, God. Holy crap. The shadow, I didn't even see.
Yeah.
Oh, man. These guys are all over the place.
Oh, man. Another butt skidder.
Oh, jeez. I was looking at this guy up here. I missed part of that. You better have some Kevlar shorts on. Here comes that King Air right there. He's on the ground.
Yeah.
Golly. Oh, the stories they're going to have tonight, huh? Did they hobble into the picnic or something? Jeez. Now he's doing full stop. Is he coming this way? No.
Yeah, he'll come around this way.
On the dirt? Jeez.
I saw one decent landing on it with a tandem. Problem is, you know, when it's hot like this.
Yeah.
Without a good wind, and the wind actually has shifted around a little bit out of the south.
Actually, it has. Yeah, you're right. Yeah. So when you were, you took a long way to get up in the air, and it felt like you were going to go, you know, climb out, and then you pull the power back. Boy, it came down in a hurry.
Yeah.
Which is, I guess, the objective. That guy's hobbling over there. No, I'm going to bug a lot of people, too. I'm going to pass. Yeah, no way. I bet they fill that damn King Air about every other flight, too.
The next chock of jumpers waiting to go.
Yeah. Here, you had this all by your lonesome out here, now you gotta wait for these guys. Get James to put that strip out of his place. I'll tell you where it is. You go over there and fly to your heart's content. Probably get hangar space. You got a lot of big buildings out there.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, just stick it in there. Unless you can join the Aero Club and fly out of Carson. Do they have an Aero Club there? They probably do.
No, not anymore. Hasn't
really?
Been one there for years.
Oh my gosh, really? Well, there's another career for you. Wow. Oh, that's surprising. I thought they would do that.
Yeah, they,
budget cuts.
There's
probably
a big, club at Peterson, which,
yeah,
you know, anybody,
oh,
any,
yeah,
any military can join, so.
Yeah, the Academy does, too. At least they did.
Yeah, well, the Academy Club, I believe it's all the same club.
Oh, probably so, yeah. Yeah, I looked into that once. I thought about it, you know, before I had my plane, about just joining that, learning with those guys, but it was just a long ways, and I forget what it would cost. I don't remember. I want to say, I don't remember what it cost now.
Yeah.
I know when I first got the Cessna in 1972, it was $15 an hour wet with an instructor.
Uh-huh.
That's a pretty good deal.
All right, we'll do another crow hop here.
Oh, okay.
So, again, the thing to remember is, don't allow yourself to climb out too high.
Right.
And then, in our case, you know, being heavy like this, it was,
yeah,
taking us a little while to accelerate. So we were still really kind of slow.
Right.
Which made it a little challenging.
Yeah, really.
It is. I actually am not a big fan of crow hops.
No, it seems
just
it's
because they're difficult.
I thought it just pull back, get her up, and then just put her down. But it's, no, it's a lot there. First of all, I'm not sure how high we were. I'm guessing 30 feet. I don't know.
Yeah,
doesn't
probably
matter.
No more than that.
Doesn't matter. When your objective is to get it leveled off, though, right?
Yeah.
And then it's going to ease back.
Right. So you got to get it up, get it flying, level off.
Yeah.
Accelerate a little bit, and then pull the power back so you don't continue to climb out.
Right.
Then you can fly down the runway for a short distance, and then reduce power and set up for a normal landing.
Right, okay.
But it's easy to get too slow, too high, all that. So you really just got to be careful about doing it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm not real sure I want to try that, right, really, to be honest with you. Oh, that damn guy's coming out again there. Shit.
Yeah, he loaded up his other jumpers.
Yeah, you got to be farting around. Well, I'll get out and see how it does. I probably won't make it tomorrow. I want to pull the plugs. I only have about four hours of running, but one of the EGTs, by the way, or cylinder head temperatures, when it was warm, they're just, oh, they're right in 20 degrees, 25 degrees, they're really good.
Yeah.
But I've got one, I think number one, the front one, I think is really slow. I mean, it gets way behind, or one of them. And then it starts popping its butt a little bit, and then after a little bit, then it'll kind of catch up, and then it's okay.
Yeah.
You think I got a plug maybe loading up a little bit? That's what I'm thinking.
It could be. Just be a little bit of corrosion in the connector of the probe itself.
Oh, yeah, okay. Cause, yeah, I'm going to take that apart and clean it up a bit. What I got, because kind of take it apart, go back to Missouri, and doesn't have a clue. I've given him all kinds of jets and sea level and everything. He's at about 1,800 feet, he said.
Yeah.
But he doesn't have a foggiest idea what to do. So after it's gone, it's gone. I gotta tell this guy. I want him to bring cash money with him, too.
Yeah.
I don't know him from the police squad. I'd take a check from you. But I wouldn't take many personal checks anymore. I wouldn't from you, of course, but I don't know him at all.
Yeah, tell him to get a cashier's check. That's the easiest.
It is, but you can forge those things so damn easily. Now, what I was going to do is have you wire from his bank to my bank.
Yeah, take him right down to your bank. And
just do a wire from one account to the other. That's done. I don't want, because you can, I got a damn cashier's check for a tractor part for $1,600. Had it for sale for $6. They sent me a Wells Fargo check for $16. I took it to the bank. This is bogus. It's wrong. It's the wrong tracking number. And the return address, they wanted to, some Islamic center in Houston, Texas, that they were the one to get the money.
Yeah.
I said, I bet they're going to be fund ISIS, for God's sake. I don't want to know. So I just got rid of it. And I've had three of those scammers now trying to nail me.
Yeah.
And I just, it's just bad news. He's taking a little while to get up too, actually. How do you know what the density, I know there's a calculation for that density altitude, but...
Well, it's, for me, it's just, I kind of know based on the temperature around here about how much.
Would you say we're probably 80 now, 85, 80, probably low 80s?
Yeah, we're probably got about between 2,000 and maybe, it's still pretty, probably about 2,000 feet of density altitude. But looking at our altimeter setting, it's still pretty high, so.
Yeah, it is. It had changed. So we're actually about 82 or 81 and a half?
Yeah.
That's about what I got down there, so. Okay.
The difference is, you're going to be a lot lighter.
7,000 overhead with diver.
What'd you say? The difference is what?
You'll be a whole lot lighter, even though you'll be departing over there at West Loop.
Oh, yeah, I will, yeah.
All right, what do you say we do one more? I'll demonstrate one more crow hop.
Yeah, that's good.
And I would recommend being very cautious. It'll be easier without the extra weight. Just be real cautious, and don't get in too much of a hurry.
No.
Because if you're just barely flying, you pull the power back and you plop it in, you can wipe the gear out.
Oh, yeah.
Just make sure you level off at, 20, 30 feet, let it accelerate a little bit.
Yeah.
And then pull the power back. Once you're up to good flying speed, then pull the power back so you don't continue to climb out.
But you're not pulling down to idle, though, are you?
No. Just reduce it a little bit.
Yeah, a little. I used to take the T-craft out in high-speed taxis, raise the tail up and feel it get pretty light, and so I pulled it back, and that was okay. But I could see, when you're going out here and you're still climbing, I mean, peripheral, I can see the runway, but I'm not sure exactly where it's all lining up there.
Okay, ready to go?
Yeah, ready to go. All looking good up here.
Slow, how we kind of dragged in a little bit.
Yeah.
So you just got to be careful not to get too slow.
But you don't have any center line view at all from where you are. Look at my ugly head back there, I know. So you just use the peripheral pretty much.
Yeah. So anyway, you may find that if you do one and you kind of pop it off the ground and you're eating up a lot of runway, you may just, skip the crow hop idea and just go around the pattern once.
Yeah.
It's a whole lot simpler.
Oh, yeah. I guess 7,000 feet of runway, which is nice. We get a damn windsock going in each direction. Each end goes different directions.
Yeah.
There's a berm right beside the highway, and there's a berm right there. And they told me a long time ago, and they're right, you can get a pet that says you're okay. All of a sudden it comes around the end of that, and then it stops. And,
yeah.
Oh, it's just swirly up there. It's a mountain right over here.
All right, I'm gonna do one more takeoff and landing, and then I'll just taxi back to the hangar.
Okay. You do it from here, yeah?
Yeah, I'm just gonna go from here.
Get your head back where you want to have it. Probably.
Much more relaxed the regular approach is.
Oh yeah.
They're trying to hurry up and do that stupid crow hop.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. You're right. It's a lot.
Gotta cut through the grass here.
Oh, you're landing here. God. Got a little bit of a leaning Tower of Pizza angle to it.
Don't be making fun of my tires.
No. Especially not these. See, I like these tires. They're great. Where'd you get them? I get some more of those. You added about, God, they're 21 pounds apiece. God, they're heavy.
Yeah, they are pretty heavy.
They're heavy. Yeah, the one I put on there are 9. Carlisle, they're wheelbout tires. I got them at discount for $13 apiece. Hell of a deal.
All right, Gillen.
Well, to quote old Bill Morse, he always said, well, we survived death one more time. I always felt kind of a relief to come down.
Practice go rounds.
Down right to the point where you either had the landing made or you can see that you had some problems, but either way you just go around.